What's up, everybody? I'm Derek Gamer. Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're back with some more Monster Hunter Stories 2. And this is going to be the ultimate guide to battling, gameplay, and doing better and getting better at the gameplay. Over the years, one thing I realized is people always come to my video and say, DJ, because of you, I'm better. I'm better in Dark Souls. I'm better in For Honor. I'm better in Longsword. I'm better in Monster Hunter. So my goal in this game is to make you better as well. So a couple of things. You guys might have been playing the game for a little bit of time. You might be new. You might be experienced. So what I'm going to do is cover from beginning to advanced tips in terms of like battle. Because there's a lot of videos out there that talk about like genes and like all kinds of combinations, which I'll get to a little later on. But the number one thing you spend the most time doing is in battle. So I want to make sure that you guys are set up for success and you know what to farm and what to keep and what to keep out of your party with weapons and monsties. So my family, without further ado, let's dive in. So how should we start this? So we'll start this way. We'll look at our equipment first. So there's three different levels of weapons you can have in this game. There's two per type. There's two slashing, which is the sword and shield and greatsword. There's two hammer weapons, which would be the hammer and hunting horn. And lastly, you have your piercing weapons, which is gonna be the gunlance and the bow. So why does this all matter? Because different monsters are weaker or stronger, resistant to specific type of weapons. And we'll showcase this all in the battle. But initially, you can equip all three weapons at once, which is the most efficient and beneficial. That way, when you're going up against a monster, you can be in a position where you can do the most damage and maintain optimal damage. And again, I'll show this all in the video. So for one, just remember there's three types of attacks. There's slash, there's blunt, and there's piercing. And it's gonna be very important going forward. Next thing you wanna look at, there's three different types of attacks as well. There's speed, tactical, and power. And this is a rock, paper, scissors game, meaning speed beats power, power beats technical, technical beats speed, which makes sense. If you're gonna be super strong, I'll be faster than you, so you can't hit me. Makes sense. If you're gonna be super fast, I'll be smarter than you, so I'll get you. And if you're gonna be super technical, I'll hit you with my power before you can even come and put a plan. So essentially, it makes sense the way that they did it in this game with the rock, paper, scissors. So now that you know what you want to make sure you do, you want to make sure you have one monster in your party of each type, which takes up three slots, meaning you have two free monsters. You could do whatever you want with your favorite monster. You go to sleep with it. You got a little statue in your bedroom of it. That's fine. Keep it in your party. But you must make sure you have three different types. That's going to be very important because in this game, in battle, you're going to be switching out your monsters based on how their monster is reacting. And all again, this is just the groundwork for what we're going to show in the battle. We're going to have two fights. I have a controlled environment, which is going to be the arena. And we're going to go against Xanthrios and a Nargacuga. And we're going to switch our monsters, switch our weapon based on what they're doing so we can react to it. This game is turn-based, but it's very, very intricate because when I get done playing this game, my brain is just going crazy because of all the calculations you have to do. There's attacks, there's double attacks. We'll get into all of that. The goal is to smack the monster before it smacks you and to receive a least amount of damage to your body, to your character, to your monster as possible. So for this, we're not even going to dive into genes and builds and armor. None of that matters. The only thing that matters is all that stuff should be taken care of. You prep for that already. Now, once you get into the battle, what you do here is what we're going to be focusing on. Let's go ahead and get into some battles. Like I said, this is going to be a beginner, intermediate, and advanced guide. So you get into a battle. First thing you want to do is you want to kind of remember what the monster type is, because based on the monster type, you're going to make some changes. And initially, you're not going to know because you're going to make a mistake, and it's okay. And also, sometimes you're going to forget because there's times I'm fighting. I'm like, wait a minute, what was this monster again? Once it does its attack, and then you know. One thing I've noticed is when a monster gets aggro, it typically goes to power stance. Not all the time, but sometimes. But there's gonna be a couple variations as the game evolves and gets more detailed. monsters are going to be switching between stances multiple times in a fight, which will allow you to stay on your toes to make sure you get the most optimal outcome. So enough talking. So this monster we're fighting right now, I know for a fact that it starts off in a technical. When it's night in this situation, it's chilling, it starts in technical. I know when it puts its ice mantle on, it goes into speed attacks. Then lastly, I know when it gets aggroed, it goes into power. So this is a good monster because it goes through three different formats of attack in one fight, which allows us to showcase everything. So this is what I was talking about. There's power, there's technical, and speed. So initially what I want to do is, I know this monster is technical, so I'm going to use a power attack starting off, because if we go head to head, then I know I'll win that interaction. So how do you know if a monster is going head to head? Very simple. On the screen, you can see that there's a line be going between from the monster to one of your characters. And if you notice, you see over here on the Frostfang, that means they're going to go head to head right now. So Frostfang, this is a technical monster. It's using a technical attack. It's going to be a draw. What happens in the draw, nobody wins. The damage gets decreased on both sides, and you go back. If you win the power, you do more damage, and you take a little bit of damage. If you lose, it does more damage to you. Makes sense. So now, I was talking about slash, pierce, and hammer earlier. As you notice, if I look at the different parts of the body, three things happen. It shows a flashing, meaning if I use this weapon of this type, a slashing weapon on the legs, the stomach, I will do good damage. If I use it on the head, I won't do good damage. So essentially, I wouldn't want to do that. But cool thing is, you have the option to swap your weapons in the middle of a battle, and it doesn't take up your turn. But if I swap it this round, I can't swap it more than one time in a round. So I have my sword and shield out right now. This monster is going to be a tentacle monster, so I want to use power. Couple of things here. Because the fact that he's not looking at my Narga-Kuga, I could literally leave my Narga-Kuga out here, and the speed attack is about to do, it'll connect, it'll be fine, and do the damage. But if I want to be smarter and do a double attack, or, and just in case it is looking at me, what I will do, which I'm going to do right now, I'm going to switch my Monsty. So don't feel like you have to. This is a Pokemon. You can use multiple monsters. You don't got to be like Ash. Only stick to one. I know initially I stuck to one monster, but the cool thing is they share experience so that they all level up at the same time. So what I want to do is switch my monster to a power type, which is my Anjanot. Bring him out. So now when we do our attacks, he's doing power, I'm doing power attack as well. So go ahead and do that. So from the parts of his body, I'm gonna hit the legs, the stomach, or the head. I'm going to focus on the head. When you break the part, it goes away. So what that means is, say I'm left with only the head and I love using my sword and shield, I'll just pull out a different weapon, hit that body part, and we'll be good. But for now, let's hit the stomach. So here's my attack, head attack, head to head, draw. Look at that, decrease the damage on both sides. Boom. So now it's coming for me. So it's going for her. So cool thing about this as well is double attacks are important, because you want to do more double attack, because double attacks skip the monster's turn. So if you notice right now, Angela using a speed attack. So I can keep him out here because it's not being targeted at the current moment. So I'll leave him out and we'll do this fight. This time, if I want to, the head's already broken, the legs are good. Let's go ahead and focus on the stomach and break the stomach. If you break party parts, it drops an item. So it's beneficial for you to break it. That way you drop it. If you notice too, I'm going to do really, really good damage to that body part as well and the monster. So now we'll go ahead and connect those two. So she won. Boom. I got a critical on there. Good damage. All right, the part got broken. More speed attack. This is the one that you have to keep on spinning your wheel. And that's how you do that one. I know for at first I was like, how do you even get that one? So now it's coming for me. It hasn't changed stances yet. It's still in this standard stance. So I'm going to continue to use power. So I'll keep Anjanot out here. So me and Andrew, I'm about to do a regular. He's about to do Burning Blast. I'm about to do a power attack. At this point, it won't do a double attack. We do a double attack when there's a regular attack, two of them at the same time, at the same, look in the same direction. So head to head. I won that engagement. He won that one. Burning Blast. And Ice Cyclone. So let's see, next round. It did decide to change his body type. We might do one more fight because I want to showcase it switching his body type. So I got Angelon out here. Let's see if we get a double attack. Boom. So we got a double attack now because Angelon was doing a regular attack. I was doing a regular attack as well. Did big damage to that body part. And now we skipped the monster's turn. We skipped the turn, meaning that we didn't take any damage that round. And we get to continue the onslaught going forward. This is the moment we're waiting for. So we use Ice Mantle. So now the monster is now in speed mode. So from here, I'm not going to use Angelon anymore because if these two go head up like they're about to, then they will lose the battle. It'll be a draw. So essentially in this situation, what I want to do is bring out a Monsi that's going to be able to withstand that when it's in speed mode. So what monster I'm going to bring out is my technical one, which would be this one right here. And now technical attack. With me, I'm gonna do a regular attack so it could be a double attack. Boom. Boom. Now the monster didn't even get a chance to do his attack. We didn't take that much damage at all in that battle. Got the monster to skip his turn, and we optimized our attacks. So the second monster we're gonna look at today is gonna be Narcacuga. Narcacuga's a good one because Narcacuga does not have any, it has a high resistance to slashing on every part of his body. So if you notice, on every part of his body, I have a line through the slash. So that means that I'm not gonna wanna use that weapon at all. Also too, it has a heavy resistance against blunt weapons too. So I'm not gonna use my hammer, I'm not gonna use my hunting horn, or my great sword, or my sword and shield on this monster. So what are my options? My options are to one, that's where this game gets more in depth. You want to level up all of your weapons because I've done a terrible job here, but this is for demonstration. What you're gonna do is pull out the bow. And now when you look at it, I have a good, the only part that's not gonna do amazing damage is the tail. But if you hit the head or the stomach, you'll do some really, really good damage. So now Narcacuga. Narcacuga, as you guys can see, is a speed monster. It starts its attack in speed. Then when it gets aggroed, it goes into technical. So if it's in speed right now, I want to use a technical monster to fight it initially. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take Shadow out of here. Take out my Narcacuga. Bring out my man Zam. That way when we start doing our attacks, it's doing technical attack. I'm going to do a technical attack. Let's go ahead and go for the stomach. He lost because they both did speed. But we're in good position right now. Now it's coming after me. So you're doing a speed attack. It's not going after you. No one else doing a technical attack. So we're not going to get a double attack. So what I'm going to do in this situation, I could also come down here and you can choose what attack your monster is going to do. I didn't show this earlier, but say you want to use a special ability. You come down here. You could tell it what attack to use. And it tells you that's a technical attack and it will use it to win in this situation. But in this right now, it's going after me. So I'm gonna tell it use Ice Spear. It uses our kinship gauge in the bottom. Let's go after the head. And I'm just gonna do a regular attack, technical on the head. Double attack. Boom. There's multiple ways to get a double attack. Through attack or through a special ability. He's using technical attack. I'm using technical attack. Everybody's using technical attack. We're gonna win this one. So we gotta just skip one turn already. So here, I will use just a regular attack on here again. Because our next thing we're focusing on now is we want to, if I want, I'll do the same thing. Ice Spear. Let's go after the head. I do a regular attack on the head. Excuse me. Double attack again. Boom. Skip this turn again. Now it's angry. So now, when it's angry, technical attack is no longer where we want to go. Now it's in technical. Now I got to use power to overcome it. So in this situation, I'm going to take Switchlight Monsters out, bring out Anjanot. I know. A lot of things happening right here. We're just getting started. Bring out Anjanot. He's going after him. He's using a power attack. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do a power attack as well. So Anjanot, he has no attacks right now. This one hits all enemies, so it wouldn't work. We just had to hit the same part, essentially. So I'm going to come out. I'm going to do my power attack. And let's go ahead and go for the stomach. So I'm power attack, power attack, power attack. Of all three of these power attacks, I should double up at least one of them. It better, but someone else is hitting the stomach. So now we're in position. He's technical. I'm power. Let's go. Boom. Critical there. Power attack. It's sharpening his blades. We won. Boom. We took a little bit of damage, but it's okay. We still won that engagement. So that part is broken now. The only part we have left is just one. So now he's about to do a technical attack. No one else is doing a power attack. So I want to hit a combo on anybody. So now essentially what I can try right now is switch my monster again. But I'll bring you out. If I had a guaranteed fire attack like this one, Venom Strike, hit that. I'm gonna hit a power attack. Hit that. We're good to go. So I'm not really worried about what happens on that side because we're good. All right, took a little bit of damage there. Now he's poisoned. So now essentially we're finished. He's gonna win the altercation because power versus tentacle. I'm gonna win. Essentially anybody else can do whatever attack they want and it's gonna connect. The goal is to net get to not lose head-to-head attacks. And essentially that's why it would be good to have a head-to-head monster, because that's exactly what I'm doing. This would be a head-to-head build. I could change my genes to be focused on head-to-head attacks and give me strength when I do that. Switch out my monsters and make sure they're going head-to-head to do even more damage. So that could be a swap build. So there's multiple options out there in how you want to play the game. It just depends on your playstyle, how you play, and what you find fun. So now we're essentially done with the video. We talked about fights, we talked about skills, your monsters, swapping them out, swapping your weapons, when it makes sense, when it doesn't. So essentially, if you on this monster, it has no parts other than this part. So if I was using my sword and shield, I will switch to my bow because this is the most efficient way. I wouldn't use blunt either. Other things you can do, you can use items in the middle of the battle. Riding, the strat with riding is all you gotta do. You can ride if you want. We had to put your kinship gauge to 100. When you get to level 3, you do even more damage. But I always like doing a couple attacks when I get into ride mode, then use a kinship skill because it's kind of like your ultimate. But Narukuga's done. That he's gonna win that battle. It's probably not gonna last past my attack. Just healing us up. Cool. A double attack here. Boom. Out of here. Narukuga's finished. And ladies and gentlemen, that's how it goes down. The ultimate guy for battling. The number one thing we do in games is our gameplay and battle. So I want to make sure that we know all the things, all the tips. If I forgot anything, put it in the comment section below. Yes, thanks for watching. If you got to this point in the video, but do a smooth family forever in the comment as well. Hope you find value in this. Add some more tips below. Make sure you follow us on YouTube, subscribe, follow us on Twitch. That's where we stream. Give the video a thumbs up. Supports me. Till next time, dear gamers, signing out.